based on the concepts that everyone worked on this past week, the goal for this coming week is to take what we look at today and to build some initial draft prototype of your concept. So it may not have all the bells and whistles, the full functionality of what you're imagining. The goal is to at least get something in place where it's a functioning app. You have a home screen that has some sort of image that's representative of your project, that might have some sound associated with it. It might have a few buttons, and you tap on one of the buttons and it'll take you to a website or a 360 video, or maybe some interactive component where maybe your user can take a selfie and upload that to a shared message board. So you can start to see some of the functionality of what you can do with the AR app. Again, with augmented reality, the idea is that the background is going to be the background of whatever environment the user is in. And you're layering in these virtual elements. So we're going to be creating those virtual elements, and we'll be talking more about how you connect the two in some later classes, but I just want to get folks into the application and start thinking about what can be done and some of the basics. So again, the link is on the assignment. Studio.gometa.io is the homepage for Metaverse. And the first step in getting started is to click on the Get Started button. Super easy. So you will need to create an account. You can do this now, follow along, or do this and just watch the demo and work after, however you prefer to work. But it's very quick. You put in an email address. You need your new school address. You have to create a custom username. And it doesn't do too much customization based on user, but I would put in student because that might open up some educational pieces. The whole application is free, so you're not going to be charged anything. I'm all for free options with these tools. So once you create the account, I'm going to just switch browsers because I already have an account. You will see a screen like this. The next step that you'll need to do is to download the app on your device, your mobile device. So here, I'm gonna share my screen right here. So in the App Store, you'll see I have the links here as well. But in the App Store, if you search for Metaverse, same thing for Google Play, for those of you on Android devices, Metaverse. Very first one, right? So download the app, and you can see some of the demos here, right? So some of these virtual elements layered on top of wherever the user happens to be. So you can be standing on Fifth Avenue and looking at a Omega watch or diving to an aquarium, all kinds of cool things, pretty nifty app. So once you download the app here, I'm gonna start over here. I have a few test apps going on. You'll see an icon here, you'll be able to launch it, and then you'll be able to scan a code that's generated by what you create in the web browser. So the Metaverse development environment, you don't have to download any software, everything is done via your web browser. And it's pretty good in terms of browser platform compatibility. I haven't run into too many issues. I do see some better interface coding on the application side for Metaverse in Safari, for those of you on a Mac versus Chrome. There's just a few minor things that it's still, everything still works, but everything seems to be a little cleaner in Safari. And Chrome takes up a lot of memory too when you're running it. So you know, I always use Chrome. So we'll keep this in our back pocket for now. So all the development work is gonna be right here. And you'll see when you initially log in, once you create an account, it's a very quick 2-minute video that'll give you an orientation, but I'll walk you through it right now. And right now I just did a quick test experience with my new school account, which I just set up, but I'll take you through that as well. It'll be empty for you if you're just creating the account for the first time. So the first step here, we're just gonna create an experience, and I'm gonna create a real project here for us. So I'm going to create an augmented reality app based on this online game I created called Trump Virus. And just to give you a sense of what that's about, so this was an online game, and you can see it here, and you can play it. I can add some background here. So you basically go through and...
Coronavirus, this is their new hoax. No, I don't take responsibility at all.
Oh, okay, I can't listen to that. So it's an online game, and so this is what we're going to be creating now. It's going to be the augmented reality app version of this game. So kind of promoting it, maybe thinking of different ways that this application could be not just a game, but maybe through the augmented reality tool, it could be other interactive immersive parts to it. So maybe some public health guidelines in terms of juxtaposing virtual elements, because you can't see the COVID-19 pandemic or the coronavirus directly, but the virtualization of it, maybe ways of helping on that front. Or on the more political side, maybe use of the app and using ads and views will be translated. Any ad revenue from views that the app promotes may be directed towards specific presidential or senatorial races in certain states. So there are a couple of different facets of it that really fit, hopefully, with the concept and some of the guidelines and customer journeys or journey persona mapping that everyone did this past week. So I'm trying to mimic that a bit. So the first step is now we're in the metaverse canvas, right? Just like the canvas in Photoshop. And you can type in the name for the experience. So the project name is called an experience, the application name is called an experience. And you can type in a new name. You've got your little navigation here that lets you zoom in and out. Essentially, it's kind of like a mind map. You're able to add different scenes. So scenes are what you as a user would see, and you can map it all out in the canvas right here. The other component on my desktop, as always, my desktop files. I've got my Trump virus project here, and I created a folder for AR app. So just like all projects, even though my whole development, everything I do in the build is going to be online, I still like having a build folder because I never know what I might want to put in there. I have an input folder where I collected a bunch of images. So I'm hoping that the metaverse work would be fairly simple. Maybe what you'd be spending more time with, at least in this initial week, is just getting familiar with the environment, but then looking at your project and saying, well, what are the images that I want to use in the app? If there's going to be sound, you may need to collect some sounds or do some work in Premiere or whatever audio tool you prefer and get some audio clips that you can work with for the augmented reality app. Or your 360 video, just having maybe a shortened version of that you want to include in the AR experience. So these are all the ingredients I sort of prepackaged for our demo today that you can draw from. And all that can go in your input folder, in your AR project folder, so you know exactly where it is. If you're editing some of the video, that will be geared towards the app, or editing some of the audio, that can go in the build folder. Really not much to put in the output, although there may be certain files that we'll be exporting from Metaverse that we'll get to later. So it's always good to have that there as well. Okay. So when I start importing things in, this is where all the files are located on my computer. With Metaverse, like a lot of our applications, you'll notice that everything is basically kind of clickable. When you click on some sort of element, it's just like in Photoshop. You select one of the tools, then that top layer becomes sort of fine-tuned things for that tool. The same thing appears here. If I click on any element in the canvas here, all the things that kind of pop up, anything that relates to this particular scene, you can edit, and those controls appear in this right-hand window. So this opening piece is going to be an AR, is going to be the type of experience that we create. If you select background, the background for the AR will just be whatever is in the user's environment. So it will be my real-life office back here. If you select background, you have to create a real background from it. So there's some instances where maybe your app starts, certain parts of the app will have kind of a controlled environment or an environment that you design, and other parts of the app will have the user's environment. So this is what gives you that control. There are other sort of default layouts, buttons and all that, colors, controls. We'll get into some of these details in a moment. So the first thing that you want to do by default, the first scene is what you see here. You can change this, but the first default scene has three parts to it. The first part is just something where it'll just be like a hello message. So it will be like, welcome to the virus. No need to be afraid. Yes, very helpful. All right, so you can just type that right in and that will pop up in the VR environment. If you click in this middle area, you can insert an image. So one of the things that people like about Metaverse is that when you become an author and start using the environment, you can also share your assets to the Metaverse community. You cannot share them too, but if you want to, a lot of people do share them. There are all of these PNGs already all set to go for you. There's even like animated GIFs. So if you want to have like a rotating figure or Giphy cat elements, you want the My Little Pony unicorn in your AR app. There's all these assets there already, and they're all available for use. I think it's part of the Commons library, and also like a library of 3D models. So we'll get into more of the 3D model work. If you want to create your own custom 3D models or import other 3D models from other programs, we'll talk a little bit more about that as part of our segue into Unity, which is much more of a 3D gaming and VR environment. But they have a lot of default, if you want to X-Wing or TIE Fighter or Robot Dinosaur, it's a pretty extensive library thing you can kind of search for elements that may apply to your concept. For the most part, I'm hoping we can use our own elements. So I think everyone in this class has some digital production experience. You can create your own videos, your own files. Any sort of image that you create, unless it's like a photograph that you're displaying in a slideshow, they should be a PNG. So everyone knows, right, in Photoshop, if you cut something out, it's on a separate layer, there's nothing around it, it's a transparent image. So you won't see the edges of the file, you hopefully will see the edges of whatever object it is that you want people to see. So I did that here, click on image, go to your desktop, and in my input folder, I've got my little Trump virus icon created, hit choose. There he is. Oh, so hideous. Okay. And you can give tags and you can give it a name. So here I'll call this Trump virus icon. It is a 2D image, so make sure you select that. You can import, upload 3D files, model files. Again, we'll get to that later. You can tag it if you want, you know, especially if you're sharing it live for community use. Oh yeah, why not? Go for it. Oh yeah, Trump virus, coronavirus. Okay. Save. All right, and there it is. Ooh, hideous, hideous. Okay. The bottom part here are buttons. So let's start off with a button and let's make this really simple. For this first one, let's call this, so I clicked on the button and you notice now the right-hand menu changes. Let's call this play game. So this is just gonna link to the existing game. All right, so you're in the AR app, maybe they've seen the game already, but if they haven't, they download the app or they view it through the Metaverse app and right away they can play the game. So you name your button in that way. And the next thing you do is you have to create another scene that that button will point to. So to add a new scene, you just click on add new. And for this one, because the game is on a website, is a website, I can select web view scene. And there it is. And again, just like all the scenes, I click on the scene and I've got options to edit it. I've got advanced options, I don't even need that. But here, HTTPS, Trump virus, and copy and paste that URL or just type it out. And you'll see it even shows me a little preview of that. And you'll notice that there's these little alerts, right? So whenever you see the alerts, that's a sign like, hey, something's not right here. So what you want to do is you want to click on the alert and you want to make sure that you're saying that, well, this button, we want, if people tap on that play game, we want to go to the game. So you go over here on the right-hand side, not only can you name the button, but you can also say, oh, transition to a scene, right? Go to a scene. And you can select the scene, right? This one's called scene 2. You can rename the scene and call this game. This is more clear. And it gets updated once we go out of it. So I can call this the home screen, just to keep things tidy. You know, I'm one of those folks who really likes naming all their layers in Photoshop or Illustrator and XD, just so that we know exactly what every element is. It's a good habit to have. So let's, and then you'll notice there's still another alert. So what happens once they're done playing the game? How to, like, you don't want to get people stuck, right? So I'm playing the game. Okay, what do I do now? you want to give people the option to maybe go back to the home screen. So you can click on that again. And once you're playing the game, once you're done with the play, the game, and you want to go to the next scene, again, it can be transition the scene. And you can say, go back to the home. And it'll just take us back. And you'll notice these lines sort of appear automatically. So let's test it. Ooh, it's exciting. So let's see what we have. Well, it's like we've been baking, and now we're going to take a little taste. We bake something, and let's see how it is. So to test, all you got to do is tap on this little test button here. And you'll notice that this little icon appears. So on your phone, share my phone again, all you got to do is go, oh, I was in my Metaverse app. Go to your Metaverse app. And you'll notice at the top here, there's a scan code. I can hold up the right point here. And tap on that. And you'll see, phone. So you just kind of show the QR code. And then you'll notice on your phone, this middle part is the phone I'm looking at here, you'll see the experience pop up. So you want to play the experience. Ta-da. And you'll notice, there's the Trump virus. Do not be afraid. So you can see that virtual element that we created is now layered on top of my desktop setup here in my real space. And you'll notice down below, there's the button for play game. So I just tap on that play game. Oh, and there's the game. I can play my game.
No, I don't take responsibility.
No. We're injecting some bleach into Trump.
And the coronavirus. This is their new home.
And you hit next, and then you're back to the home screen. Okay. So even easier than creating a website or anything else, like just incredibly straightforward, simple tool. Any questions to this so far? Well, we'll keep going. But before I dive deeper, anyone lost, confused? It's fun, right? Questions? Okay, let's just do a few more things. And okay, so here we can just tap anywhere to close out of it. Let's try a few more things. So let's start and add a few more buttons. Let's try to add our 360 video. So if you didn't create a 360 video, no problem at all. You can link to an existing 360 video on YouTube. No problem at all, but just to show you what that looks like. That's pretty cool and connects with what we were just doing. So this next one, the next button, let's call it Risky Spaces 360 video. Okay. So that appears, and maybe I want the game still at the top. So if I want to change the order of the buttons, if you hold down the control key, so I'm holding down the control key while I click on the button, a little pop-up appears and there's a move down option. I can also delete a button this way too. So I'm just gonna do move down, oops, move down. So there's my Risky Spaces. The Risky Spaces button is gonna take us to a 360 video of like a gym, which, you know, gets us less if you're wearing a mask, but we're gonna go to a Zumba class virtually. It doesn't really make complete sense, but just for demo purposes. So again, I clicked on the new scene. And let's go to our 360 video scene. Ta-da! And the same idea applies here. So we want to click on, well, first let's do things right then. We'll do, this would be our 360 video. So I'm renaming the scene. I can click on the little alert here. It transitions the scene. I want to jump to the scene, so that's right. I can select the scene. But let me also show you, in addition to selecting the scene, because once you start really working in a tool like Metaverse and you have a lot of scenes, it can get a little crazy. So instead of searching through a long menu of scenes, you can also click on this little icon here, little finger pushing. If you click on that, you can click on the scene that you want to link to. So if I click on the 360 video scene, you'll see that it links now. The line now for the Risky Spaces button is now linking to 360 video. Okay. And you can also like move things around to make the lines more apparent. It's a little better. So same thing here. I can click on the scene and I can put in a URL of a YouTube video or wherever the 360 video is located. But I'm going to upload a video. So I prepared a little short version of that 360 video because I was super organized and put everything in my input folder. I can find it right away. And there's a little clip. I'm not sure about the file restrictions. Generally, I don't have these like huge, giant 360 videos embedded into AR apps. I'm trying to give an example where that would make the most sense. But generally, they're kind of shortened clips so that you're going to a single environment looking around where a few things were to happen. Or if it really is just purely about the environment, then maybe it should just be a 360 photo. Just to save on files, because you don't want to be uploading like 2 gigabyte 360 video files to Metaverse. Again, I don't know what their capacity is, but any web-based application, you don't want to be dealing with files that huge. So hit continue. So we got our video. I can see a little preview here. And again, the same thing. Once you want to get out of the video, I want to transition them back to the home screen. All right, so it's a lot of lines back and forth, but everything's connected. All right, let's test it again. Everything auto saves. So for anyone who's done a lot of production work and are, you know, I still have that command S Twitch where it's like, oh my God, is it saved? Everything auto saves. So hopefully you don't have to worry about losing any work. So now again, if I want to test it, I click on the test option and I go to my phone. And what is my AirDrop? Too many windows open. Same thing. I go to the app, Metaverse, and you. I have to quit out of the experience I was testing before. So yes, exit, close, and scan code again. This one. There's the new version. They changed the background color just so you know it's a new version. Hit play, still got that nasty Trump guy virus right there. No need to be afraid. And this time let's click on the risky spaces. So here right away, this is kind of cool. So now as I kind of move my phone around the room, it's like I'm in that space. I can put these in my goggles and get a similar experience. You'll notice that there's the little icon just like you see in YouTube in the corner. So you can, I think I tap on the button instead. You can also do it in the headset view. Metaverse does that by default. And go back to that home screen. All right, and I can click on the play game as well. Easy peasy. All right, let's do one more thing. So let's add one more scene. This time, we're going to get a little fancier. So again, this week, I want folks to kind of think about the initial setup, create some of the assets that you'll be using for some of the more functional pieces later, but we'll be getting to the more functional pieces in the coming weeks. Because A, I don't want to dump too much stuff on you, and B, there's some really cool things that we can really delve much deeper into once you're a little bit more familiar with the environment. So this time around, we are going to do a camera scene. Right? So the camera scene will allow the user of the AR app to take a photo and upload it into some shared space, like a wall that you can have all the users post images and share them to in a public form, in a public place. So anyone using the app would see those files. So the first thing you want to do is to add the scene of somebody taking the selfie. Okay? So you would, again, click on scene one. You want to, this button specifically, you want to transition this to take a selfie. Right. So it's pretty logical, right? We're on the home screen, we click on that button, it takes it to a screen, a pre-built, pre-programmed screen where the app will let the user take a picture. And then the next step would be to add the functionality of the save to wall block that I mentioned. So now we add that little functional component, the little gear, the mechanism that makes it all work. So we click on use, that pops up here. So now once they take the picture with their camera, it gets there's a little tool that takes that picture and now is going to save it somewhere. So now we have to add somewhere where that picture will be posted, right? The wall, the actual wall that the user sees. So one of the scenes is called a wall scene. A wall scene is basically something that collects any kind of data. So you can have a wall with people's comments about whatever it is that you might be collecting. It could be videos, it could be photos, it can be any sort of media. It's a way of displaying that. Because remember, the scenes are all about what the user sees. Right? It's the action that's happening inside the app versus the blocks are what makes the action happen. So we want to add a wall scene. Right? Same page I found because we haven't added the wall yet. And for both the media wall itself, as well as the functional piece of it that takes the selfie and posts it to that wall, you have to make sure you click on that piece and you say what the data wall is going to be. So remember, we created that wall. If you didn't do this before, let's do this again. New selfie wall final. It wall, okay. And the scene that has a wall on it, you just have to tell the scene that, oh, we're going to use this COVID selfie wall final, right? It's the same wall functionality as a little tool widget here. So once you created that, you have to just make those same connections as we did before. So you'll notice that those alerts are still popping up. After you take the photo, you've got to send the user to the next step, which is saving, creating a little tool piece of it. And then you select the save to wall piece. From save to wall, you want it to point to the selfie wall that will collect all the pictures. And then once you're done with all this, maybe it takes you back to the beginning again, right? That makes more sense than what I showed before, right? Because I don't know what I was thinking. So you have the button, you point it to a scene where you can take the selfie, you pull one of those blocks in that we'll be talking more about that provides some functionality within the AR app, right? So basically whatever picture that people take that scene for, called the selfie, it takes that picture and then it puts it onto another scene. And both of these scenes, you have to create the data wall. I know it sounds confusing. This is the media wall scene. This is the data wall where those pictures will be stored. Right? So you have to tell the functional piece of it, hey, we're going to store those pictures here. And you have to tell the scene, which is what the user sees, that, hey, this is the data wall that you're going to display in the scene for the end user. And I think I did that right. Let me do a quick test. And again, we're going to go into our app. And screen mirror is working, hooray. And we go back to our Metaverse app. I can get rid of that. Exit the old app, close, scan code, and do our new experience. Voila. Trump virus. Let's play the experience. There's our Trump virus. And now we can take a COVID selfie. So now it's going to the screen. Oh, I have my blocker on. So here I am. And you'll see that because I chose photo or video, I've got both those options. But if I change that side menu to just photo, you wouldn't see these two options, you'd just see photo. Or if I selected just video, you'd only be able to shoot a short video clip. So I'll do a selfie. Oh, that's not flattering. And then next. So the minute I clicked on that next, that's when the save to wall function came in. It took that selfie that I just took, and then it pushed it onto that COVID selfie wall final data wall that I created, and then is now displaying it. What we're looking at right now on the phone screen right here is this scene here, the COVID selfie wall final, which is displaying that wall we created. Does that make sense? I did a terrible job explaining it, but those are the different pieces that you're just creating the instructions of what you want the app to do. Good. So I would like folks to try to give this a shot. And again, this may not make sense for your particular app, but just to get a little bit of the taste of the coding before we get into things that are, you know, not necessarily more complicated, but follow that same type of logic. So again, the steps were create a button on the home screen. Let's just do the selfie screen. Here on the selfie screen, you can choose photo and video or photo or video only, whichever ones that you want. Connect the two, again, just by selecting the button and clicking on the arrow telling where it should point to. You want to add a new block, right, that captures that photo that people took. And then you want to also add a wall where the data will go. And then you just have to create, oops, I didn't want to do that. And then you want to, for the block, create a new wall where that data will be stored. And then just make sure the media wall is pointing to that same wall to pull that information from. So let's add a new YouTube scene. All right, so let's say you have some sort of promo video for your business, product, or nonprofit, whatever you have in mind. Same thing here, you would have to put in a YouTube link. I'll copy and paste something. So now the step one for creating, linking the modules is just, there's a button here. So let's just call this like a launch video. And all you gotta do to link an element together is, if you're linking from here, from the home screen, from this button to this YouTube scene, you're transitioning from here to this scene. So all you have to do is, you know, click on this alert thing and transition to, this button I changed. Sorry, let me delete this. Because this was, I created this as part of that selfie demo. Let's start again. Watch video. And when you click on that, we want to transition to, meaning move from one point to another, transition to the YouTube scene, which here I'm going to rename it. It's called scene four now, but I'm going to call this YouTube. You just select that scene and Metaverse will automatically create that connection. So I didn't draw that line. All I did was click on the button, give it a name, and then tell it where it should transition to. And again, if you if I add the YouTube scene, and I create a button called Watch Video, I click on the button. And transition scene, if it's like a long menu item, I can just click on this button here, click on it, and select the scene that I want to transition to. And then Metaverse will automatically create, let me move this down so you can see it, will automatically create that line. Down, right? So now we have Watch Video links to the video. And then now, once they're done watching the video or they want to stop the video, you click on the same scene. And now we want to transition back to the home screen. So all you do is select that and it goes back. Or likewise, if I click on here and I want to go back to the home screen, I can just click on this button, select the home screen, and then I'll loop back.
So basically, the scenes are created on they are numbered by the time you create it. Yep. So if you create the scene number, so scene number three is that's because you created after the two first ones.
Yes, yes. So it's actually kind of smarter than you realize, because remember I created this and then I deleted it, but Metaverse is automatically calculating calling the scene 4 because it's the fourth scene in the canvas right now. But again, I really like renaming the scenes. Just so I can keep track of it. Because I hate opening up the menu. Just like I don't know if anyone else has a pet peeve. You know, when you open up a Photoshop document that like a colleague or a friend sent you and it has 573 untitled layer. You know, oh my God, it's awful. Same thing happens with a lot of these AR applications. If you click on the scene, imagine if there are like 100 different scenes in your app, which is fairly common. Scene 1, scene 2, and scene 500, it's really unreal these. So always try to name your scenes just so you can keep track of what's going on.
Okay. Thank you.
Sure. Other questions? Here, instead of recreating this, let me show you the other. So the other, so everything's saved. Hopefully. Back to category, back to my homepage. So this is just like the quick test that I did. So again, you can go in, so anytime you create a new experience, they'll all show up on your main page. You can click on them, go and edit, you can share them from the screen here. I think I took that out. But yeah, it was exactly what we said before. You create that functional module, you look at that screen, and when you test it, you take the picture and it just gets added to a wall. I can redo that functionality if you want to see it. But it was really just intended as more of an intro piece of it. We'll get into more of the mechanics in later classes. I just want people to set up their project and just start getting used to laying out different scenes in Metaverse for week 1. All right, any questions? Okay.
I did have one. For the home screen, you said you could change the background of it, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh yeah, actually this is good. Let me show you a few things. So you can change the background. So you'll notice like when I looked at it on the app on my phone, it was like just the background of the of my office here. If you select background, then it'll give you the option to upload different images that could be the background, so you won't see whatever is in the user's environment. The other thing you can do is you can click, and there's also the option for adding a frame. So what a frame is essentially static elements that appear in the middle ground of your AR app, right? They don't call it background because they didn't want to be confusing. The background is whatever's in the user's environment. The frame is in between the virtual elements that you're creating and that real life background. So let me just show you what that looks like. So if I click on add a frame, I can create a new frame, and essentially I can upload images, but here I'm just going to, just for demo purposes, just drag a few from over here. Oh, yeah, just taking a second to load. Birthday cake, right? So if I save this, I've saved a frame. And those elements here, let me show you what this looks like. I'm gonna write that. Yeah, I'm still in my old app. Close, scan code. There we go. So those elements just stay. It's a frame, right? So it's just there on your app. So okay. So the reason they call it a frame is that you can create this decorative frame with like ornate frame or something that just stays around the perimeter of the phone. So I guess in this case, the virtual elements are in the middle ground and the frame is sort of on the same level as the buttons. Yeah, and then if you do a background, then you won't see all the stuff in my office, but the background will cover up all that. Okay. Let's see if anything else. Last time I did a metaverse demo, I kind of went through everything, and people were just like, oh God, that's way too much to digest. So I'm hoping that was fairly straightforward. Let me show if you have a little more time today. I might show you a few more of those functional blocks just so you have a little bit more familiarity on how that works. But that's really the essential. So the assignment this week is really to take a look at your concept and figure out maybe just from this is like beta version, not even version one, it's kind of like 0.0.1, getting some aspect of your concept into the AR environment to start building it in Metaverse. And to create something like I did for Trump Fires, like this isn't the end all be all of what I want to create, but it's a starting off point and has some of the media elements to it. You can also add sound. You'll notice that for each one of these, for a lot of these, if you mouse over a certain scene, you've got additional options that pop up here. So here, this is where if I wanted to have static elements around the camera of my phone, I can add a frame here. I can also add a sound. So I can go in, and if I want to greet users with Trump talking about this hoax or that hoax, I can go in and hold my mouse, try for the sticking. Anything you select here, that awful bleach comment that you made. Give us a new name. What was it, disinfectant? You have to say disinfectant. Disinfectant. Injection. Okay, save. And that audio will play when that scene opens. So this will be the first thing that pops up. And if it won't work with some of these video ones because the audio will be in the video, but you can add sounds to these clips as well. So I'm hoping that everyone for this week can set up the project, create some PNGs that you can start importing into your project. This also accepts animated GIFs. If anyone makes animated GIFs in Photoshop, you can do that as well. 3D models, if anyone's doing that, but again, we'll do that together in not too long. Create a set of buttons. So at least one button that'll link to a web page. I have this all listed out on the assignment. One that goes to a web page. And if you don't have a web page for your project, you can link to maybe an existing web page somewhere that relates to whatever topic it is that your app is addressing. Have another link that points to a video page. Again, it could be your video or a video that relates to your concept. And and maybe we'll go through that upload feature one more time as well. Maybe add a sound clip. Everyone did a great job on their audio pieces. So maybe just take a snippet of that and add that to the home screen or another screen within the app. And that's it. Just to get things started. And once you are ready, so the testing allows you to see the app. To share it, you'll have to publish the app. And you can publish it so that no one else sees it. So I don't want people to see this yet. I can go under advanced, and you can list it under unlisted. So just like YouTube, no one's going to find it unless you send them the link. Cloning just allows other, and this is part of that kind of sharing piece of it. If you see a really cool metaverse app and the author has chosen to clone it, essentially it's like a template that you can use that, hey, I created something really cool. I want other people to use it and improve upon it, do something great with it. If you want to give people that option, you do allow cloning and they can actually start working from what you've created in metaverse and build from it. They're not overriding your project, they're creating a duplicate. Or you can say double line. And then this is just what the icon will look like in metaverse when people access your app. So I'm gonna go ahead and publish it. Publish. And then this is what you would be uploading through Canvas. So for this week's assignment, it's asking for a URL submission. Submit your share link. And as always, it's an exercise. So if you're able to set up those buttons, link to those different scenes, make sure those things link back so that we don't get stuck within the app. We're good to go. That's really all I'm asking for this week. Questions? Good. Once you have this link, you can also use it yourself. So anytime you'll see it in your app as well, and you can see it through the testing and the QR code and everything that we saw before. But this is what the link is that you see in the share link. So anyone with the Metaverse app can put their phone over the QR code and they'll be able to ask the app that you created. And then